Hello my friends, wishing you all are doing good. In my last lab, I integrated Data Power, API Connect and Developer Portal. After that, I created one sample API and we published that API and we run that API. So in that lab, we didn't implement any kind of securities while accessing that API. So API Connect basically provides three kind of securities. As if we will use API key, basic and auth. API key is basically if you want to pass client ID and client secret into headers. The second is basic if you want to integrate your API connect with the LDAP. So you need to pass the username and the password. You have to create the username into your LDAP and you need to set the credential for that user. Third, we can use auth. So you have to create one auth API and you need to call that auth API into your actual API, and we can use different kind of auth. So for today's lab, what I'll do, I'll use the first kind of security, that is API key. We will create one app, our developer portal, and we'll create client ID and client secret there, and we'll use that keys and secret while accessing our API. So just make sure all your servers is up, your Data Power, API Connect and portal shall be up. Okay, so let me log into our API Connect first. I logged in my API Connect, and to log into our portal, what we can do. Okay, we'll log into portal later. Let's set up the security first. So first we'll go to our security definition. Here by default, when you will create your API, you can see one security. Like here, if you go here, you can see API key, basic and auth. Okay, so by default one header you can see here, client header, but I didn't select this client header here yet in security. So we'll add one more head, API key here. So we'll click on API key and here you can just mention client secret. Okay, and into security we need to select both checkbox here. Okay, so save here, and what you need to pass into header, whenever you go to security definition, you need to pass this header name there and this header name. So what we'll do, let me copy this one here and we'll paste in our text pad. We'll get this value from the portal. So how we'll get those values, I will show you. So how we can see the URL of the portal. In my last video I showed you, I'm showing you again. We'll go to setting and then portal. So this is our URL of portal. Okay, so just copy and paste here, login. I already showed you steps how we can create a user and user will get the activation link. If you missed that thing, please watch my previous video. Okay, so here we can see the API and the products. We created one welcome API and we'll do one more thing here. Now we'll go to assemble. We'll go to the API. In the assemble we use simple gateway script. Here we'll use welcome with security. Fine. And save it. Let's go to our portal. Okay. Here we'll go on the home. We can see some APIs whom we have to give the access of our publicly view. So those API we can see on the home page. On the API products, we can see the API and the product which are assigned to us. Okay, in the apps, we'll see we have one app, so I'll create new app here. Okay, the app name will be the welcome. Okay, and you can just mention the description if you want. Mention if you want, the address is fine. Okay, and if you are using any auth for this, you can mention here. We are not using auth here, so we are not passing any values here, so submit here. So first time when you'll render to this page, you can't see your client secret. To just see to your client secret, you need to click on the checkbox. So here you can get your client secret. Okay, so better you need to copy somewhere this values, so if you will not miss these values. Okay, and to see the client ID, you can see the client ID here. Just copy this one also. In one app we can create multiple client ID and client secret. Okay, and one more thing, if you forgot your client secret, you can't get that client secret again. You have to again to create a new client secret. But if you like, see here, let me go to the back page, I'll show you one thing. Okay, let's go back to our welcome. Here you can't see your client secret again. If you miss your client secret, you have to reset it again. Okay, but client ID you can see whenever you want. Like if I click on client ID, I can see my client ID, but here is no place we can see your client secret again. So better, that's why you shall keep your client secret to save somewhere, so that you can retrieve your client secret again. But if you miss it, you can't get the same client secret. So next time you have to regenerate that client secret. Okay, so we'll pass this client ID and client secret. Okay, so after creating client ID and secret, we need to subscribe the plan, and we need to choose the app for that client. Okay, so we'll go here again in the apps. Okay, we can see here no subscription found. Okay, for this app, so we can see what all are the APIs available here. So we'll go to the product plans. For this plan, this is default plan, and hourly we can access this API 100 times. Okay, so let's subscribe it. Okay, here we need to select the app which we created just few minutes back. Subscribe it. And whenever it will be subscribed, you will see the message successfully subscribed to this plan. And you can see this thing in API Connect also. So here if you go to your sandbox, okay, in the sandbox go to community. Here you can see the applications. We created the application. Here you can see the client ID, what is belong to that app. But you can't see the client secret here, and you can see the organization is Sandeep Kumar, and the status is active. Okay, and we can see the subscription. In the subscription, we can see the product name is the welcome, and the application name is welcome, and organization name is Sandeep Kumar. So whatever you are doing here, you can see in the API Connect as well. So let's run the application. Okay, so before that we need to publish that API again. Okay, so we'll go to drafts, sorry, API. We can publish the API from here, and if you want, I'll tell you another way also. Okay, if you can publish from here, otherwise what we'll do, we'll go to the API Okay, select your API, go to a sample, and from here you can publish your, and here you can see your sandbox and your product. Okay, so republish this product. It takes some time. We'll do one thing. We'll first we'll test the API without passing client ID and client secret, and we'll see the behavior, what kind of message we'll get. So if you don't know what will be the actual URL of the API, just invoke from here, okay, and you'll get this URL from here, okay. Just by invoking, you'll get the URL here, okay. So I have Postman. I already copied. I have pasted that URL here. Okay, so first time we'll go to the header part. Okay, as it's a get method, we don't have any body. So in the headers, we'll not pass any key. If we'll not pass any key, so we'll run that. Okay, so here we'll get code as 401. Okay, and HTTP message would be unauthorized. Okay, and in the information, you can see invalid client ID or secret. Okay. So because we didn't pass the client ID and the client secret, so we can see here that client ID and client secret is missing. Okay, so how we'll pass client ID and the secret? So we'll copy from here, okay, and we'll write here. And we can see those logs in our data power as well. Okay, let's log into data power as well. So we'll go to the API connect domain. Okay. So we'll go to the logs. Here we can see that client ID is missing. Okay, client ID is missing. Okay, let me pass the client ID first. Okay. Okay, we'll not pass the client secret, and we'll see what message we'll get. Okay, so same. Okay. We got the same message, client ID or secret is invalid. Okay, and we'll see the logs in the data power. Here we can see your secret is missing. Okay, so I'm highlighting this one, secret missing or incorrect. Okay, so we'll pass secret as well. So let's run it. Okay, after passing valid client ID and client secret, we got some message. Okay, let's see. Client ID, client secret we have. Okay. Yes, we can see here. So this is the message, welcome with the security. Okay, whatever we passed in our gateway script, we can see here, welcome with the security. Okay, if you want to see that, this is the welcome with the security. So after passing the client ID and client secret, valid client ID and the secret, we can access the API. And in case if you'll pass, let's say if you'll pass the wrong client ID, it will not work. Though we are passing client ID and client secret, but if any of the value is you'll pass the wrong, it will not work. So if you'll pass the wrong value, it will not work. Okay, so let me copy the correct client ID. Okay, so here the valid client ID. Okay, and this time send first, it works. Okay, let this time pass the wrong secret, okay, it will not work. So whenever you pass, you need to pass both client ID and the client secret, and both values shall be right one. Because why you need to pass client ID and the client secret? Because in the API security, you opted both client ID and the client secret. Okay, like here in the security, you have checked both option, client ID and the client secret. Okay. So in my next video, I'll cover how we can create the definitions, okay, and how definition will work, and how we can I'll try to cover more topics now, like how we can create and we can use the security while using the OAuth. Okay, like here the security part is also mentioned. In the security definition, we can use basic and OAuth. I don't have the LDAP, so I'll try to cover, but I'll tell you how we can use the basic. We need to just pass here in the authorization your key, and like if you are using the basic, okay, wait a minute, here basic OAuth. Okay, so here you need to pass the whatever username and the password you have created in the LDAP. You need to pass that username and the password. Okay, so I'll try to cover more topics, like how we can in the mapping, how we can use arrays like that. I'll try to cover those things for this lab. This is all about my this lab, how we can add the security headers with the client ID and the client secret. Thank you guys for watching my video, and stay healthy, keep doing exercise. Thank you.